Honorable Member Srimati Vandana Chavan ji, you have 7 minutes.
उनको आज ही बोलते सब तैयार करो इतने कुछ समय में
बिकॉज इन्वॉल्व्स डिफरेंट फ्लेवर्स ऑफ आर्ट क्राफ्ट्स डांस फेस्टिवल्स फूड कल्चर हिस्ट्री हेरिटेज ट्रेडिशंस नेचर एंड एडवेंचर एंड ऑल्सो शोकेसिंग ऑफ मॉडर्निटी सर बट देर इज सो मच टू स्पीक ऑन बट देर इन माई लिमिटेड टाइम आई विल लाइक टू रिस्ट्रिक्ट माई सेल्फ only to the stark reality that is happening at the moment in the tourism industry and that is the plight of the travel agents and the companies who are facing hell in the covid after the covid times some of them in my region have approached me and given me a long list of the problems that they are facing and I think these are very serious issues that they are facing which challenges their very existence and the operations So according to the United Nations World Tourism Organization, the year 2020 has been the worst year on record in the history of tourism due to the pandemic. And therefore, India is no exception. When the lockdown was declared, tours obviously were cancelled. Customers and clients started asking the travel agents for refunds. By then, some of the bookings were already made. Travel to the airlines, trains, road transport was already booked. Hotels, packages of the tours were booked. After that, sir, ugly situations have arisen because these customers or clients started asking for their refund, and this was not possible. Some of the offices were ransacked. Serious allegations were made, and threat calls were made to these people and agents. But unfortunately, they were helpless. There are a lot of litigations now in the consumer courts, and this is adding fuel to the fire. The Travel Agent Association, sir, have expressed pain and deep frustration over the plight, and further much anguish that the government has not said a word which will show that the government is really considering their plight and ready to do something. And this just doesn't seem to be in sight for all of them. I would like to read some of the requests from the registered organization called Enterprising Travel Agents Association, Mumbai, through their representation to me on 6th August 2020, which is very relevant for consideration of the government. And it says, there are a list of demands, and sir, with your permission, I would like to read them out because I think they are the most relevant, and the ministry needs to give very, very serious consideration to them. Number one, they say that the TCS, that is the tax collected at source, that will be implemented on 1st October 2020. Then, of course, that is a letter of August 2020. It still continues. Should be deferred by 3 years and the amount be reduced from 5% to 2%. Second, that they say that reduction in the credit card swipe machine charges, which is currently 1.75% to 1.5%, as this would encourage clients to use digital mode of payment. So this charge also, sir, needs to be reduced. Third demand that they make is they should get a GST holiday for a period of 12 months. Fourth demand that they make, that making the international online travel agencies like booking.com, hotels.com, etc., the OTAs, to register in India, making them liable to pay taxes. This will create a level playing ground for online and offline travel agencies. The fifth point they wish to make is provide a bailout package of fund and support salaries, rents, electricity to agents registered under MSME and GST. The sixth point they make, sir, is interest-free term loan to travel agencies for a period of 3 years without collaterals. The seventh, refund from airlines directly into the bank of the issuing agencies in the case of LCC airlines, that's Indigo, SpiceJet, GoAir, etc., and the GDS airlines, that's Air India, Vistara, etc., refund should be made into the bank account instead of credit vouchers and credit shed. To which, sir, these were the points that they gave me in the letter, and now they wish to further say that the RT-PCR test required should be standardized for travel through all the states. There is one set of rules in one state, another set of rules in another state that keeps changing. So there has to be some kind of portal where all states are given equal treatment, number one. And secondly, it should be easily accessed to the travel agents and people who are traveling. Another point which they wish to make is need for coordination between states and centers for development of tourism post-COVID. And the 10th and last point they wish to say is conferring an official status of industry to the tourism sector, because they are not taken otherwise seriously. So if nothing is done in this direction, the tourism industry in our country will face large-scale bankruptcies, business closures, job losses, and will never be able to revive and recover. This, sir, I wish to say and tell the Honorable Minister, is absolutely serious, and I think steps should be taken in that direction with right earnest. These are the points of the travel agents. My second point, sir, which is also very important, and I'm voicing this on behalf of the central government employees. I mean, the World Economic Forum has come up with a roadmap post-COVID as to how they would move forward to revive the tourism agency. I don't see it happening in our country. I don't see any steps being taken. I may be wrong if it's happening. I think it needs to come into the public domain so that a sense of credibility, a sense of assurance will be lent to the travel agents and the people who wish to travel. So that kind of statement needs to come out. And one of the features that the World Economic Forum or several agencies which are coming out with a roadmap say that at least encourage travel which is within your country. And here I would like to bring to your notice, sir, an issue of the central government employees. I was also surprised to note that our central employees get a hometown leave travel allowance once in 2 years, and an All India leave travel allowance once in 4 years. So if an employee is staying in Delhi, he doesn't get a home travel allowance. If, say, he's staying in Pune, then he gets a home travel allowance. I think the government needs to encourage people to travel, because this is what will revive the economy. And therefore, my suggestion to the Honorable Minister through you, sir, is please reconsider, revisit these norms, and let us bring every year anywhere for the central government employees. I think that will also help the economy and help the central government employees to travel whenever they want to visit their children or for medical help, etc. The railway employees are given passes when they are in service after retirement and after death also to the families. So just half a minute. So this should be extended to the central government employees also. And my only last point is that there is a dire need of a tourism policy, not just for the center, but for the state and every city, because that's where the economy really will revive in these places. So thank you very much, sir, for giving me this time, and I am sure the Honorable Minister will consider all these demands that I have put.
Thank you, Honorable Member. Honorable Member.